Hello guys, welcome to my channel and I am Shanjivan Ghosh with you. I am solving the new solution of the NCERT book of class 10 of exercise 4.3 of the chapter quadratic equation. And you can find out this question in the page number of 88 of that book. So friend, first of all, I will tell that who are new in my channel and who are viewing my video for the first time. So please subscribe my channel just to get more videos in the future also. And if you are already subscribed my channel and hit the bell icon, then you have already got the notifications too. So without any kind of talking, I am starting the video. We have already solved out the question number 8 in my previous video. You can check this one by the given link in my descriptions too. So I am starting the next question, that is question number 9. And this question is very much important for any kind of competitive examinations and in any kind of examinations too. So this is called cistern and tap kind of question. So first of all, I'm reading out the question for you. What is the question? Two water taps togetherly can fill a tank in a 9 hole 3 by 8 hours. The tap of larger diameter, that means a larger tap, takes 10 hours less than the smaller one to fill the tank separately. Now we have to find out the time in which each tap separately fill up the tank. Right guys, so first of all, we don't know what is the time taken by the both of the tank to fill up the tank separately. So I'm taking first of all any one as x. I'm taking the smaller one as x. You can also take the larger one as x also. Let the time taken by smaller tap to fill the tank separately is x hours. Right guys, therefore the time taken by larger one is equals to, you can see here the larger tap is taking 10 hours less than the smaller tap. Now I have taken the smaller tap is taking x hours. That means the larger tap will take x minus 10 hours. Right guys, now in x hours and x minus 10 hours, the first one and the second one is filling up the tank totally separately. That means they are filling one part of the tank. Now I am finding what is the part of the tank filled up by them in 1 hour. Right guys, in 1 hour the smaller tap fills, obviously it would be 1 by x part. Right guys, you can find this one by using the unitary method also, but if I use this one the sum will be longer. That's why I'm not using, I'm telling only just right. By the similar manner, the larger tap fills 1 by x minus 10 part. Right guys, now we need what is the total part they are filling up in 1 hour togetherly. Therefore, in 1 hour, they togetherly fill 1 by x. We have to add these two quantities. Right guys, 1 by x plus 1 by x minus 10. You can do the simplification here or in the equation line also. I'm doing here. The choice is yours obviously guys. And you are getting from here 2x minus 10 by x square minus 10x. Or you can take common 2. It would be x minus 5 by x square minus 10x part. Right guys. Also in the question it has been told they are togetherly taking 9 whole 3 by 8 hours. Right guys, therefore By the question, in 1 hour, by the question, in 1 hour, they are filling 1/9 whole 3/8, that means 1/75/8, that means 8/75 parts, right? Now, according to the question, this quantity and this quantity should be equal, right, guys? So I'm doing this one. According to the question, 2 into x minus 5 by x square minus 10x is equals to 8/75, right, guys? And I'm cancelling this one. This is becoming 2, 4, and I'm multiplying diagonally. It would be 75x minus 375 and equals to 4x square minus 40x. Now, just to make an equation, I'm taking all the quantities on a one hand side and the remaining one on the other. And on the other hand, it is becoming 0. That means 4x square minus 115x plus 375 equals to 0. Right, guys? So, first of all, we have to multiply A and C. Then we have to factorize. That means 4 into 375 is giving you this one. You can see here 1500. And you can easily see if you take from here 15 and 100 as the factors and add them, you are getting 115. Right, guys? So I'm taking this one minus 100x minus 15x plus 375 equals to 0. You can take common 4x from the first two quantities that you are having x minus 25 and minus 15 from the second, then it would be x minus 25. Right, guys? And it is becoming x minus 25 into 4x minus 15. Right, guys? So, you are having either x minus 25 equals to 0, that is x equals to 25, or 4x minus 15 equals to 0, that means x equals to 15/4. Right, guys? Now we have to take the next one. Therefore, the smaller tap takes 25 hours. Therefore, the smaller tap takes 25 hours, or you can get from here there 15/4 hours. Right, guys? Therefore, the larger tap takes x minus 10, that means 25 minus 10, that means 15 hours, or 15/4 minus 10, that means 15 minus 40/4, which is less than 0. You can easily see 15 minus 40 is obviously less than 0, which is minus 25. Right? So we cannot take the value 15/4 as our answer. Right? Therefore, the time by smaller tap is 25 hours and by larger tap is 15 hours. Right, guys? So this was the total solution, and I'm very sorry for making the video on the exercise book. And thank you friends for watching the video. Keep supporting me and please subscribe my channel and share it with your friends if you think it useful too. And thank you very much for watching and supporting me.